son of a bitch!
What's up? Oh, what's up, Dro? What's going on, man? Yeah. You wanna meet up tomorrow? Alright, cool.
Well, what's happening?
Somebody got the drop on us. Check surveillance, check everything. We have no idea who.
Is it the cops?
I don't think they have the technology or the inclination we want to even be able to pull that off.
You're supposed to take care of it, no?
I'll take care of it. One way or another, I'll take care of it. I gotta bring everybody down with me. This will be taken. This will be finished.
Okay, this is too important, too big. And every time you come with this, I'm just seeing your face too many times. You need to take care of it. You're number one. That's what your job is.
And this will not happen again. Like I said before, this will be handled. We didn't lose any of the shipment. It's just...
Are you going to take care of this crap? I'm tired of this bullshit.
Yeah, it's going to be taken care of.
I don't have time or patience for these problems. You need to take care of it.
It's going to be taken care of.
So go ahead, and I don't want to see you until you fix this problem.
Yes, sir.
Selling it, all the haters wanna check.
tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that, on that.
Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that, on that.
Just bought a Cadillac. Rich boy selling it. All them haters wanna check. Tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that, on that.
Just bought a Cadillac.
Throw some D's on that bitch.
Just bought a Cadillac. Rich boy selling it. All them haters wanna check. Tight, no slick. Just bought a Cadillac. Took it to the top, top. Got the damn top drop. Two color flip flop in the red lollipop.
It's freaks in the parking lot.
But I still got my cock. New money, mother. Don't you see the big dot? Don't you see the big chain? Don't you see the big grills? Wonder who they hating on lately, baby. This hill. Candy paint, gated skin seats. Call me Dundee. Hoping you hood, I'm the one that you wanna be.
What do you think's going on over there, man? No one's hit us up yet.
Cosmo. Yeah, I got good eyes on him. I see everything that's going on.
You did good on that. That's a good. That's a good.
Who's that? Oh, that's Sean, man. Local Hustler's little brother, bro.
Talking about Caesar?
Yeah. You know Caesar, man. Yeah. No, this is his hood, man, so we got to kind of be respectful toward him.
See what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Someone else coming up. I don't recognize him.
What's up, homies?
What's up, Sean?
Jerome, what's up, man?
None. Just trying to make some ends meet, bro.
Who is this cat?
My name is Red, man. What's up? What's going on?
That's your homeboy, huh? You say he cool. But how y'all just gonna come over here in my hood, man, and try to eat off my food?
Man, he out there trying to help me get some bread together, dude. Going through a little trying time right now.
We starving out here. Not trying to take food out of our mouths, man. You can get killed for stuff like that.
But I'm trying to get all that situated, man, so we can all be on the same page and get this money together.
You're supposed to ask me before you come over here like that.
Nah, man, no disrespect, man. We need to meet up with C's.
Yeah.
Try to get on the same page, man, so we can all get this money together.
Mac, are you getting this?
Yeah, I'm getting this. I'm getting it all.
Who's that guy?
All right, man, well, I'm gonna have to check with Caesar on that one, but I know he ain't gonna like it, you know? But I'll run it by him, see what he say about it, but y'all gonna have to pay a percentage, man. Simple as that.
Are you getting this? Are you looking this up, man? See what you can find out about him.
When is Red supposed to call you?
Matter of fact, let me go ahead and hit him up, man. I see what he got to say about it.
Yeah, set that up, man. You got me?
Mac, it looks like they're leaving.
Oh, shit. He's going with him. He's going with him.
Bass. It's Cosmo. Yeah. All right, Red's leaving. No, we're going to follow him.
He just got in the car. He's going off of Almondale right now. You gotta hurry up and get behind him.
Yeah.
Look, I'm gonna get in my car. I'm gonna try to follow him. Let me know. Keep me updated. Let me know where they are.
All right, let's go.
Man, where's he gone?
Finally. We were getting somewhere. Sean took me and Jerome to go meet his brother Caesar, the man who was running things around in this neighborhood. We knew that Caesar was getting his supply from an outside source, a contact. A contact that belonged to the same crime family that Brossard did. I quickly understood that I didn't want Jerome and his family to get involved any further, so I did anything I possibly could to try to get him out of this. It wasn't easy. But I was able to persuade Jerome to back out, but still keep my angle on Caesar and stay undercover. Now all I had to do was explain to the captain how we were going to move forward with the investigation, now that Jerome was out of the picture.
So tell me, what's going on?
Look, Captain, Caesar. You know, when we was in there, we were meeting with him, he tried to take a big percentage from us, you know what I'm saying? And it was just too much of a percentage. You know, any self-respecting drug dealer would be like, no, I'm not dealing with that, you know? And Caesar, he wants to be kind of an intimidating figure, You know, he tried to intimidate us. He intimidated Jerome. Jerome didn't like that. Jerome decided to get out.
This is not a good situation right now. You know that. You know, our sources were relying on his information and for him to infiltrate this organization for us to get the information that we need to go forward with our operation.
I understand that. You know, now he's gone. Regardless, he's gone. But check this, right? There's another way we can do it. I've sold the product. People have seen Red's face. They know who I am. All right? So, you know, I figure I keep hitting the streets. I keep building up my rep. I already have a good rep, and now I just keep continuing building that rep. And by that, you know, me and Bass, we hit the streets, hit a couple of areas, still hit Caesar's territory, and then sooner or later, Caesar's gonna have to come and see what's up with us, because we're gonna be taking volume away from him. And anytime you take volume away from somebody, they're gonna have to come check you out.
Well, let me tell you like this, because this is what it's going to boil down to. It's going to boil down to whether or not you're comfortable with him. You know, one of the things about being undercover is basically being undercover and not allowing your position and your identity to be blown. Now, you're bringing in another individual into the operation and not really having any explanation as to why this other individual is going out. You see, there could somehow be a conflict of interest, and that's what I'm concerned about.
People in the street know who I am. They've seen my face. I've sold merchandise to them. You know, I've given them product. So let me and Bass hit the streets. We got Cosmo and Mac backing us up. You know, if anything goes down, they'll be right around the corner. You know, and I think we can go that way. I'm very confident with that.
Well, I can only say this. I mean, you guys are out there in the field. I mean, you are the operatives out in the field. But I'm not at all comfortable. I'm not 100% comfortable with the situation. But I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt, and I'm going to allow you to do what you feel is necessary. But I need a report on my desk,
yes, sir.
ASAP, and I need to know exactly what your point of contacts are. And I'm gonna need to know what your overall layout, your overall plan is going to be in this situation.
Captain, there is gonna be some things that we're gonna need in order to pull this off. You know, we're gonna need some gear. We're gonna need some drugs that we can sell. You know, we can't be top-notch drug dealers if we don't have anything to sell. So we're gonna need some drugs, and anything that's gonna make us look like we're top notch, you know, like we're legitimate drug dealers. You know, we can't be going out there half-stepping.